Breakers, funnels are in a bad place. I know there's a lot of people who have beloved funnel builds from Breaker 3 that are a little sad their EX is now and you can no longer spam a million of them. But the badness is mostly down to the mechanical changes. All funnels are now shot-based, which is fine, but a lot of them don't have the damage or frequency of fire to really cause an effect. Now that said, there are a handful of really good funnel options, but those funnel options are usually ones that have utility. Options that do certain specific nice little unique things over just raw damage that makes them more than worth running. If I had to highlight four here, I have a small list. First and foremost, let's talk about sea funnels. These are the Shigeru blades on legs that the HFX uses. They're only a base of one bar, and when they go out, they act as funnels. They go, they fly out, they run into people. Still shot-based for some reason, because that's a flying knife. But tapping that button again turns them into a barrier mode. This is where the value is. So not only as a barrier do you now have a boosted physical and beam defense, but just contacting someone deals an amount of damage. This is fantastic if you're combining it with an aggressive melee style. You also have that bonus protection, that's the same kind of buff that pyramid types, like for example, New Gundam or Akatsuki Shiranui have with their barriers, while having damage on top. It's really great for only one bar. Now that said, something I want to point out, even if you use the builder's part sea funnels, like I have here on my butt and my feet of Beetle, and you want to link multiple together, the cost will be increased accordingly, but the actual damage of the barrier will not. The damage of the funnels themselves will be boosted a bit, but not enough to really make up for three bars. And since the barrier is really the way to go, you might as well just keep it as one. Now, for my own sake, I just want to throw it back on there. It's going to bother me if it's not. Next one I want to talk about is GN Fangs. These come from the Archy legs. They are also just beam sabers that fly around. But for whatever reason, they're coated on shot. And what makes them extra nice is not any kind of advanced extra mode. It's that on hit, they stun the enemy. 1 or 2 seconds, they're just shut down. The builder part version that I have on my back right now only fires out two for these two racks. The legs fire out a good dozen. Now, funnel damage on the actual shots and stuff is inverse to how many are out. If I use the builder's part that just fires two, the damage per shot is going to be about 2,000. It's going to be more than these, you know, 6, 7, 8 out. But it's not going to fire as frequently. So if you really want to take advantage of their effect of having that stun capability, you're going to want to use the legs, whether it's a master or as the legs themselves and just work around the cosmetics. But that stun potential is really nice. In fact, when I see a Archy come out in any kind of new type difficulty game mode, for example, that monolith mission you have to do with Tao, I target it first, because these will mess me up. If I get caught by these, the new type enemies can shred me. In a similar vein, Rose Bits and Rose Screamer off of Rose Gundam Left Arm. On deployment, they go out as a regular old funnel that shoots around, but if you tap the button again, it turns into this handy little funnel cage that you can instantly select a new target for that completely shuts down the enemy as soon as they're involved in it. This also comes on Rosen Zulu Backpack. It makes a little pyramid instead of a field, but it's the same effect. And these can be excellent when combined with other funnels, since you take away the RNG of missing a moving target by having them just locked down. The AoE is not bad either. And the final one I want to kind of highlight is a dual purpose here. Either the Providence or the Legend Dragoon System back. Fires out a series of dragoons, which are just the cosmic era funnels, that instead of weak little shots, are these concentrated beams that not only stagger for a longer period of time, but have a much wider area of effect. And the bigger ones fire off those spread styles. That's really good for catching multiple enemies, as well as just tearing through bosses with multiple hitboxes. Now, there's a couple neat things you could do with the Providence and Legend specifically. Providence does not have this feature, but Legend, if you hold the button instead of pressing deploy, you actually get a beam blast. So it's got a little bit of versatility built into it. It's still only 2 bars, which ain't a bad thing. And if you have the fashion space in your build to equip either the Legend or Providence legs, in addition to whichever one you're using, you actually get additional Dragoons. In Legend's case, you get those two sitting there on the waist. In Providence's case, you get a whole ass four off of those side skirts. They will fire off in addition to the skill, and just give you a few extra beams floating around there for a little more utility. It's not vital, it is going to reduce the overall damage of each hit, but the frequency of their attack kind of makes up for it. But it's your choice of whether or not you want to use them. As you can see, the master version of the skill still uses the legs, so you got a nice little option select there. One final honorable mention would be Strike Freedom Super Dragoons on the backpack. It is a little special snowflake. These are not actually dragoons. These are not, rather, for the sake of skills, these are not actually funnels. This is a hyper trance that for 4 bars instead of 3 deploys funnels at the same time. Now, since they're not actually coded funnels, while they'll still scale on shot, they don't get bonuses from funnel EX damage traits. But since they are slaves to the duration of the hypertrance itself, if you boost the duration of the hypertrance with ability capsule cartridges or any other trait, these will stay out longer. All in all, having all this nonsense together in the same boat, you can have some really oppressive funnel builds. You just have to use up some EX slots for it. So get those GN Fangs out, get those Sea Funnels rolling around you, get the Rose Bits, get the Dragoon System. Just lock them down. Funnels can be useful despite their perceived lack of damage, actual lack of damage. Just gotta think outside the box with them.